Electric Machines Part 2B Section 3, Torque and Speed Characteristics of an Induction Motor. Now, this is the second part of Topic 2 in the series of Electric Machines, and this is a continuation of our discussion of induction motor in the preceding subparts, in which we discussed the slip and the equivalent circuit of an induction motor, and in this part, we will discuss the following. We will discuss the torque speed curve, the maximum or pullout torque, and the variation in torque speed characteristics of an induction motor due to the rotor resistance. Now let's first proceed with the torque speed curve of an induction motor. Now the figure shown is the torque speed curve of induction motor, which is a plot of an induction motor's synchronous speed, which is plotted on the x-axis, versus the induced torque expressed as a percentage of the full load torque, which is plotted on the y-axis. Now, following this curve from the very beginning, we can see that the starting torque of an induction motor is almost 200% of its full load torque. Or we can say that the starting torque is slightly greater than the full load torque. This curve increases linearly up the level of the pullout torque, which is the value of torque that is theoretically cannot be exceeded by the motor. And the pullout torque is around 2 to 3 times the full load torque. Then the curve dips down sharply and reaches zero at the synchronous speed because the torque developed at the synchronous speed is zero. Carrying this further, if the motor's speed is increased beyond the synchronous speed, then the machine enters into generator region and the direction of the induced torque is reversed. Now let's look at the maximum or pullout torque of an induction motor in a bit more detail. The figure below shows the effect of the rotor resistance on the motor's pullout torque and the maximum torque. Now it can be observed that if the rotor resistance is increased, the pullout speed of the motor decreases, but the maximum torque remains constant. We can say that the maximum induced torque occurs when the power consumed by the rotor resistor is maximum of the induced motor. Now let's have a brief look at the variation in the torque speed characteristics of an induced induction motor due to its rotor resistance. If the rotor of the induction motor is designed with a high resistant, then the motor's starting torque is very high, but also at the same time, the slip is very high in normal operating conditions, right? And this increased slip reduces the converted power, so the motor's efficiency is also reduced. Opposite to this scenario, when the rotor is designed with a low resistance, then the motor's starting torque is low and the slip is also low in normal operating condition, which increases the motor's efficiency. Now, both of these scenarios are illustrated in this figure. Now, there is a need to reach a compromise, right, between the high starting torque and good efficiency, which is also done by using different techniques. And one of them is to use the wound rotor induction motor with an extra high resistance inserted in the starting as to have high starting torque. But it will need to be removed during normal operating conditions, right, to achieve this high efficiency. The problem is this wound rotor induction motor are expensive and they require high maintenance. And also sometimes it requires a completely sealed if the motor is placed in a hazardous environment, which is possible only in the case of a completely self-contained rotor. So that's all for this part, and in the next video we will be discussing more about the synchronous motors. Thank you, and let's keep in touch.